50 miles crowding the streets to catch a glimpse of Romania's most famous citizen. Word is spread that Nadia is coming home. The trip from Bucharest to Onești usually takes 3 hours. On this day, it took six. The drive constantly interrupted by throngs of people who came to see Nadia. Her presence had a magical effect, as though she was a Pied Piper playing an irresistible tune. Children who had never seen her compete knew the stories. She was part of their folklore.
I've only seen her on TV. We are very happy she came back to Romania.
I cried when I saw her. I came from 50 miles away for this sweet girl. She is the pride of our country.
It's a great joy to see her return to such honors after so many years.
Nadia was relieved to find that most Romanians never felt she had betrayed them, but saw her defection as a statement of independence.
I think she's the most appropriate ambassador of our country. When she left, she expressed the wishes of our people. If someone else had done it, it would not have had such an impact.
I'm really excited nowadays. She has brought us only victories. I missed her and felt a sadness when she left. We loved her so much.
In this new Romania, the demonstrations of emotion were like nothing she had ever experienced before. Nadia was cherished as a symbol of their own hard-won freedom. November 23, 1994, was declared Nadia Comăneci Day in Onești. Everyone was given the day off. Nadia's father, Gheorghe, still lives in the same apartment house where Nadia grew up. She hadn't seen him in over 5 years. Nadia hasn't forgotten. It was from her father she learned the toughness that has carried her through life. Her father and stepmother extended Bart a traditional Romanian greeting. And being the perfect gentleman that he is, in carefully practiced Romanian, Bart asked for Nadia's hand in marriage.
Okay.
And Gheorghe gave his blessing. Just a few blocks from her home, Nadia found her first love, gymnastics. She was only 6 years old when she left her family and eagerly went off to live full-time in this experimental boarding school. Here, academics were combined with intensive training in her sport. Earmarked early on as championship material, much was expected from this little girl with the somber expression.
Nadia, what's in that?
But even a child with exceptional gifts would find time for mischief and play. Her teammates had become her family. These tiny girls shared big dreams in one small room. Nadia's old room was still waiting for her.
This is the room where I used to sleep. Mm-hmm. But the bed are not the same. They, after 76, so they renovated everything. I think with the money that was supposed to be mine. the beds were a lot smaller at that time. And probably because we jump a lot on that, we kind of destroy them.
Was that like a trampoline for the...
Yeah, it is like a trampoline, I think.
Still works.
Yeah, it still works.
And Nadia was thrilled to find that one of her former teachers was still there.
It's amazing. She's going to show me my class. And the kids that they stay after me, and they're taking class here.
The children performed an ancient Romanian chant of goodwill.
Thank you.
Nadia had risen to fulfill her promise to her hometown. It was their turn to complete the circle, and in renaming their school after her, they forever claimed her as their own. The most unexpected gift was the gathering of the members of her 1976 Olympic team. They traveled from all over Romania to see her. When Nadia made sports history, these women were part of it. The years and distance had not diminished the bond of friendship which had begun in this gymnastics school in Onești. This day was as memorable as any Olympic victory.
There was something in my heart about these trips that I hope that everything is going to be okay and it's going to take a stone from my heart, but it really did. I have nothing back on my brain that I have to accomplish or I have to do something to be thankful or to meet the people that I left behind and just, you know, talk with them or apologize, or I didn't know what to do at the time when I arrived here. So I think my life is going to be really complete after that. I have no plans after this.
Nadia had proven that you can go home again. Saying goodbye is always difficult, but this time was different. She knew it didn't mean forever. Coming up, Nadia performs for the first time in her homeland in 10 years.
Why I like the Super 93.
I don't have a fear of breaking down, so I feel safe and secure with Super 93.
Well, there you have it. 9 out of 10 cars, when asked, recommend BP Super 93. BP on the move.
I have always used BP. I think it was because my parents did.
You're watching Nadia Comăneci return to Romania on ABC's Wide World of Sports.
Since Nadia's farewell, the Palace of Sport has not been used for gymnastics, but the arena promises to come alive once again to a sold-out crowd as Nadia performs on the 5-year anniversary of her defection. Certainly the crowds never expected to see Nadia perform again. Romanian tradition dictates that once an athlete retires, her performing days are over. But breaking with tradition is nothing new for Nadia. This was simply another challenge to be met.
Nervous?
Like a prize fighter about to step into the ring, Nadia prepared for one of her greatest tests. Would she live up to the expectations of the crowd? At 32, would her performance be received as warmly by her countrymen as it was when she was a 14-year-old darling of her sport? She was competing with memories.
Thank you.
to come back and take center stage, but it was a fitting conclusion to a homecoming she would never forget. Coming up, some final thoughts from Nadia.
Thank you. I'm very touched and I'm very happy. I didn't realize that my trip would be so beautiful, although I knew I had a lot of friends. I'm happy that you didn't forget me, and I assure you that although I live far away from this country, I will never forget that I am Romanian. Bart knows this very well. I will always come home with pleasure, and I will forever be at the side of the Romanian Gymnastic Federation and our gymnast who will represent us at the next Olympiad in America. I wish all of you many years of good health and a lot of joy. Thank you.
Of Nadia Comăneci and gymnastics will always be intertwined. While others made mistakes, Nadia made none. She showed us perfection was possible. Whatever her sacrifices, her ambition drove her to want more.
To accomplish those kind of results, that I wanted to do it, because at the end I'm going to say, yes, I accomplished something in my life. I didn't just pass my life like anybody else. And later I'm just going to be a worker in a factory. I didn't want to be like that.
She was the greatest physical talent ever in the field of the women's gymnastics. A strong, almost unstoppable competitive machine which was rolling over her adversaries.
When she had to do it under what I would call miserable conditions compared to our life here in the United States, that took a spirit, that took grit, that
I think there's a fighter inside, and I think in Nadia's case there's an extra spark, there's a little mischief, there's a little smile in there, and a determination to continue, just to keep going.
No one has done what Nadia's done since. There's been a lot of gold medals won, a lot of perfect tens scored, but no one has touched what Nadia did 20 years ago.
The young woman who stepped off the plane in Romania last fall is not the same person who fled 5 years ago. She was willing to risk all that she loved to leave a world we may never comprehend. When Nadia came to America, she left everything behind. In returning to Romania, she put back the pieces of her life that might have been lost forever. Accomplishment is that she has survived. Because she had the courage to go home again, she discovered the people of Romania will always think of her as theirs.
It's really important to be back now and find out what exactly the people thought about me. If they loved me, if they thought that I did a good job, if I represent the country, okay. If they are proud of me, it seems that they are.
So you're a lot of peace now?
Yeah, I am.
And is the pain over those other things?
I have no pain, just in the morning when I woke up, I'm a little hurt here with my back. I'm getting old.
It's the compelling stories of athletes like Nadia Comăneci that over three decades have been the cornerstone of Wide World of Sports. I'll be back for a final word, but first, here are scores from today's NCAA basketball tourney. Be sure to tune in 2 weeks for the Chrysler Skating Spectacular. I'm Julie Moran. We'll see you on April 1st.